How's it going here?
Oh, not too bad, but not very good, really.
Oh, yeah?
In southeast British Columbia.
Gold just disappeared on us this year, so we're hoping you can kind of help find us something.
Miner Anthony Moth joins geophysicist Nicholas Gust to seismic test a potentially gold-rich area on the 900-acre claim. If the survey shows a deep channel, it could identify months of mineable ground for Anthony.
So here's one of our seismic sensors. So these are a passive seismic instrument. So yeah, it's non-intrusive.
Yeah, perfect.
All we gotta do is plant these into the ground and then wait 20 minutes, go on to the next one. So if I want to wait 20 minutes, then go ahead.
Yeah.
If it's there, we'll find it.
I like the sounds of that.
Yeah.
So you're gonna have a report for us then at the end?
Yeah, I'll have it soon for you.
Yeah, okay. Right on.
Right on, great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
To identify potential pay channels, Nicholas will test an area spanning 335 acres. Data from this activity is analyzed and generated into a topographical map of Anthony's site. The map will identify the shape and varying depths of bedrock and any ancient pay channels, which may contain rich deposits of gold.
We're very hopeful in the seismic producing some good results, but if this ground doesn't pull through for us and we can't find better pay, we might be done here.
Guys, ready to do a test run?
Let's do it. Firing it up. Let's do first bucket, Fred. You got your timer? There it is, first bucket.
With the time run out on Anthony's deadline and no results back from the seismic test, the second four-hour run begins on pay from the current cut. Even a small increase will prove the fix's work.
You know, it's always kind of nerve-wracking a little bit, Fred. We fire up a plant that we've done this much work to, but we'll just see what happens.
Later.
Yep. Seems to be running pretty good, Freddy. Grizzlies are working good.
Juan re-welded the hinges on the hydraulic grizzlies, allowing them to open and close.
Take a look at these spray bars.
Look how clean it is.
Yeah, jet's concentrated exactly where it needs to be.
Yeah, it looks good.
The spray bar wasn't washing the material properly, so Juan made it adjustable to better clean the pay dirt.
Material's always getting hit. It's
getting a tear wash now.
Yep. That looks good.
I'm seeing some stuff that I really like.
And I think they're gonna solve a lot of our problems, but
I wanna make sure I can make this successful enough that we can all be happy and all have work to move forward here.
For me, this has been quite an adventure. I mean, I've been enjoying spending time with Anthony, and I'm looking forward to maybe coming up here and doing this some more. And these fixes should definitely improve his production, get him the pay that he needs, and to pay back some of that debt.
Well, the feeder's doing its job, Juan.
Feeder's doing good, Freddy.
In the first test, Anthony had to unclog the hopper multiple times. Freddy added a load-bearing bar for a more even feed. And finally, replaced the sluice box with new riffles to catch more fine gold.
Anthony, last bucket!
There it is, Freddy, last bucket. Well, let's clean it up, huh?
Ultimately, Anthony needs all the gold he can get. He's got a lot of responsibility. He's got a family. He's got employees here. He's got his investors. It was a good test run, but sometimes it comes down to the ground. We'll see what it looks like tomorrow morning when we put it on the scale.
Hey, Freddy.
How's it going?
It's going all right. I was just talking with Nick there, and I got the results here. Thought you could have a look at it.
Sure.
In southeast British Columbia, at the Moth Mine, as the crew prepares for the final weigh, the results from the seismic test are in.
This our depth then to bedrock?
Yeah, that's what it looks like, yeah.
It's deep there, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
80 feet. So it's 6 feet deeper than the rest of it. And it's the same down here. It's even deeper.
Yeah.
So that's a good chance it might be a channel in there. And it's definite bedrock coming up here, bedrock coming up there.
Right.
And deeper here.
Yeah.
With good gold already on the surface, a deep channel could mean a mother lode for Anthony's mining future.
That's exciting, though, if that's a channel there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Who knows what's down there? So
the old timers might have missed it.
Yeah.
Hopefully that is a channel in there, a reworked one, and it hasn't been disturbed by the old timers. If it's good, it could be really good.
It's time to weigh the gold from the second test run. The first test produced 0.72 ounces. For Anthony to start turning a profit, the final test must deliver at least 2 ounces.
.74.
Oh.
It's not great.
No.
An increase of 2.7% from the first test, but $2,500 short of their target.
Well, it's not the result I wanted to see, but we know the plant's running better.
Yeah.
So it's a pay issue right now.
Yeah.
Bad ground.
Yeah. I know that doesn't feel like a win. It doesn't feel like a win at all, but just look at the amount of fines in that, Fred.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, we never had that amount of fines in the first round, nowhere near that. So that tells me that, you know, the sluices, you know, the fine gold riffles are catching that fine gold, and then on top of that, we're actually getting a proper clean on it.
Yeah.
You know, we're just not on good ground right now, but with these fixes, when we get on it, I think, you know, we know we're going to catch it now.
So. Yep. Gold's where you find it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
The final gold weigh, it feels like we got kicked in the teeth, and we're not going to get paid. You know, it was a little bit of a gamble, but honestly, one thing is for sure, in my heart, when he gets on that better ground, I know that with what we did here for Anthony and his family, in the long run, it's going to help him out tremendously. But do us a favor, you know, when you start getting some of that better material in the plant, let us know how it does.
Yeah, yeah. We'll do. Thanks, Freddy.
Pleasure.
Hey. John, thank you, sir.
If we find something good, we'll let you know.
Please
here.
Do.
Yeah.
Thanks again, guys.
All right, thank you.
Cool. It was worth having these guys come here. They fixed a few major issues we were having. The plant's running better, and I'm hoping that we hit some good ground. It'll pay my partner back, and I can get my dad back up here.
I was looking for a big win, but like we always say, we can't put gold in the ground, right? Well,
let's head out. I'll follow you out.
Hey Freddy, hey Juan, how's it going, guys? Just wanted to give you guys an update here. We've moved down and started running that stuff that Freddy and I tested. That's the spot that we walked down there and we did those couple pans. We've stripped a bunch of it, we built a road in, and it's unbelievable. I mean, it's better than anything we could have hoped for.
Check that out. Holy.
That's a lot of gold. I'm feeling unreal. I feel so excited. I mean, this is some of the best ground I've ever seen, and it was just right here the whole time. We just had to find it.
Oh, look at the fine gold. Check that out.
Those are deep. Those are like a half inch deep. Careful not to spill that one. That's a pan of gold, eh? Holy.
So today here, we just did a 4-hour run.
That looks all right to me.
Well, it's gonna go higher, over 10. Holy.
Oh. Woo! We got 13.5 ounces in 4 hours, including the biggest nuggets we've ever got off this claim. We've had a 20-ounce day. We've had lots of 7-ounce days.
That's unreal.
Freddy and Juan, I just want to thank you guys. With your guys' fixes, everything that we've been fighting is now running smoothly. I got my business partner off my back. I think he can see now that this was all worth it in the end. So what more could you ask for?
That's unbelievable.
Now that we've got all these fixes done and we're on this amazing gold, I think my dad can come up here and be a part of this with me. And you know, he could watch his grandson grow up here mining on the claim with all of us, which is what we've been kind of wanting all along.